Hello there, Jordini here, and welcome to Jordini Plays Hearthstone. Today we're gonna take a look at Festival of Legends decks once again, and we're gonna take a look at Rulik Demon Hunter. So, first order of business, thank you for taking time out of your day to watch my content. It's so much appreciated, and I love all the support you guys have been giving to the channel lately. So thank you. If you happen to like this video, give it a thumbs up, and if you like what I'm doing as a whole and you want to see more of it, please consider subscribing to the channel. You can hit the notification bell, that way you don't miss any of our daily uploads. And if you have like any questions or conundrums of any kind that you'll like to see me take up, feel free to leave that all in the comment section. Like, I will be more than happy to talk to each and every one of you out there.
Is this the way?
For the draw into the skull. Smart. I think we're playing against our deck from yesterday here.
Who here can spell Zinjari? Anybody?
Do we have two rush minions in the deck? I don't believe we do. So, last stage is useless. Care Strike might give us card draw. Fell might give us healing and AoE damage, and let's go for that.
The Citadel stands strong.
Oh, serving the Vizier. Well, we've done surprisingly little relics. It's probably like played like a dumbed down version of Outcast. If you could draw one of our unleashed fells as a top deck, that would be very nice. That powered up our relics just a little bit. This won't help them out. Yep. As I mentioned yesterday, Frost Acro, very hard to beat. Especially if you play a little bit of a slower deck. Control this time. We don't get the outcast here, but it's still a 3/3 for 2 mana. Very much worth doing.
The citadel stands strong.
Okay, another Illidari studies.
Fresh fell steel, hot out of the kill. For Suramar. For Suramar. Saint Jeez!
free one. I'm completely fine with that. Let's do a relic. This will not power our relic of dimensions. Plus, if they manage to kill one, we can do Vizier next turn for the spot discount as well. It's got lifesteal on its own. You can see we're trying to make a setup here. Most likely have an answer here. It's minion damage. Upward, watch, Oh no. Oh, and Felorin as well.
God damn.
Your souls belong to the little king.
Of course.
Is a bone laid waste.
Oh, the snapshot would be really good right now. Yeah, that's not it. 14. Yeah, we're not gonna win this one.
I must withdraw.
I'm feeling my gameplay doesn't really do this deck just because I really think this deck can do really good. I really do. But it's just like Death Knight. You see it again. A third Death Knight in a row. Death Knights are insanely powerful right now.
In death.
I alone will shield my people.
Drop the Unleash Fell. School Cheese and the greatest, but got some good things I've heard.
Ah, I see you
and it's another control. Which means this is most likely our last game of the day. Because those control matchups tends to go a little bit long. Now a relic would be really good.
For
Steno is not really the thing we are looking for here. powers up the relic, get Steno out, we'll get 2 hits to the face. I really was worth it. I'm gonna lose it. For sure, like Steno's not gonna get to last one turn. Not against anybody. Yeah, I control deck. That's for sure. Kind of want to do the Roddy fan here.
Yeah, let's go! It's my turn. Any questions?
And then we'll most likely do the snapshot next turn. But Blot.
So the legends are true.
That's not at first. I'm just gonna kill that because I don't want them to heal off it.
Yes.
this. Then we do this. Relic wall down. And we present Lethal on board, and they have used two soul stealers now, so we know they don't have a threat unless they generated some, which is possible they could have done off the Hematurge, but it's not very likely.
The more you struggle, the better.
That's probably one of the luckiest, luckier ones. Let's go for the snapshot.
Citadel stands strong.
Could pull off a cough explosion here. That's probably the only thing that will keep them alive. Leave on board. But you know, just for good measure. This is how we can beat a Blood Death Knight with this deck. Just out of value. Okay, there are some massive boards of ghosts. Or phantasms. They can keep up eventually. So yeah, that's where I'm gonna stop for today. So, what are my thoughts on the Relic Demon Hunter? It's probably a better Demon Hunter deck to play at the moment, I would say. It's more consistent and more reliable than the Outcast, which is a little bit all in, and if you miss, you miss, and then you lose the game. Whereas the Relic Demon Hunter is a little more versatile. Haven't checked win rates on it lately, on those two compared, so I can't tell for sure if that's also the truth there, but you might have to look that up for yourself, but it might be. Like, if I would pick, like, if I wanted to grind ladder and Demon Hunter was my class, I would pick the Relic Demon Hunter. Would I just, I'm just gonna play for fun and grind out some games, I would pick Outcast because I think it's a more fun deck to play. But it's not as good for grinding. So that's my thoughts on wrapping up on Demon Hunter. Hopefully you enjoyed, and thank you if you made this funny video. If you did, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. Tomorrow we're gonna play some Hero Power Druid. I know it's not really one of the big meta decks right now for Druid, but besides the Tony Druid, there's not really anything else we can play as a Druid, so I didn't want to showcase the same Druid deck twice. So I'm playing this, and then maybe next week we'll have Tony Druid back on the list. But we'll just have to wait and see for what's gonna happen. Take care of each other out there for now, and goodbye for now, guys.